tax delinquencies are going to be one of the hottest lists to do for 2021 and moving forward. Unfortunately, this pandemic has really exacerbated some of the issues most sellers have with their financial issues. And sellers right now that couldn't even afford to pay their taxes in 2019 most likely won't be able to pay their taxes for 2020. So coming forward into 2021, I know for a fact that tax delinquencies are going to be a bigger list than ever. So figuring out what are tax delinquencies, actually how to find that list, how to market that list correctly, and lastly, how to talk to sellers and actually wholesale these for big profits is going to be one of the most important skills for a real estate wholesaler to know, especially as a beginner. So in today's video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide on actually how to find tax delinquencies, tax lien lists, and actually how to wholesale them for huge profits. What is a tax delinquent property and what is tax delinquency lists? What are tax liens? So right off the bat here, you have to pay your taxes. There's two certainties in life, and that is death and taxes. And you might know you have to pay your income tax, your state income tax. When you own a piece of property, you have to pay your local county property taxes every single year. You don't get a year break. There's no break from it. Every single year, you have to pay your property taxes. And if you don't, the government will seize your property and put it up for a tax sale. So when people or sellers don't have the money to actually pay their taxes, then the government will put a tax lien on the property and basically state, if you don't pay me back in 1, 2, or 3 years, we're just gonna put this up for a tax auction and we'll give it to the highest bidder. We'll give you whatever money's left over and we'll get our tax money. So no matter what, the government's gonna get their money. They're gonna get it from you. So it's always best to pay your taxes. But some people are in situations where they can't afford to pay their property taxes. And this is where us real estate wholesalers and investors can come in and actually help sellers with a cash solution to help them out with the property. So basically, when somebody doesn't pay their taxes in year one, so let's say they have a $100,000 property and the taxes for that year is $2,000. Now, these are just very easy numbers. That $2,000 is owed at the end of the year, usually in late November here in Florida where I'm at, or any other time in the country, sometimes at the end of the year, November, but there's usually a due date where that tax is owed. During the deadline, you don't pay your $2,000. Nothing crazy is going to happen. There's not going to be a magic tax fairy that says, boom, you don't own the house anymore. What happens is after a year, usually you don't get too much flack. You still have to owe the taxes on there. But after a year, maybe 18 months, especially after 2 years, the county or the city or wherever you have to pay your property tax will slap a lien on your property, which basically states that we are owed $2,000 on this piece of property, which basically states again that this property can't close until I'm paid. When a government puts a lien on your property for something legitimate like not paying your property tax, you can't get out of it. So what you have to do is you have to pay that tax. So they just put a lien on the property. If I put a contract for $100,000 and then I close it for $120,000 with a cash buyer, so the sellers owed $100,000 and they owe it free and clear, but they owe $4,000 in back taxes. Basically, like a mortgage, they'll just get $96,000 at the end of everything. So they just pay the $4,000, kind of like a mortgage, which means closing isn't stopped, but the government gets paid first, and then the seller gets the $96,000. Now, how does somebody become delinquent on their taxes? There's about two main reasons why, and it's pretty easy. So the number one reason where us real estate wholesalers, this is the best reason why someone's behind their taxes, and this is my favorite one, is basically when someone inherits a property. Most likely, it's a middle-aged person whose parents unfortunately passes away and they inherit a really nice property. Maybe it's like a $300,000 to $400,000 house and the person is a mechanic and they make $25,000 to $30,000 a year and they definitely can't afford the property, but they just inherit it and they just keep the house there. And year one, they're owed $6,000 in taxes. Then year two, it's $12,000. They definitely can't pay it. And now they're behind on taxes and they can't afford it and they don't know what to do with the property. It's just sitting there vacant. Now, these are just when people inherit properties, they can't afford them. So us real estate wholesalers, we talk to these sellers and see if they want a cash sale for the property. Number two is basically someone that doesn't have the money and they actually live in the property. So let's say I lost my job or I own a pizza restaurant and this pandemic has destroyed my business and I have no money. I can't afford the taxes. Then another year happens, they can't pay the taxes or these tax liens. They're drowning in the stress of that and they just want to sell the house, get rid of it and wipe the tax lien off. Now, a person like that, they don't have the $4,000, for example, in back taxes in their pocket to pay it. So if they sell it for the $100,000, they'll just get the $96,000 and then it's paid off from that. So yes, you know, tax delinquencies are an amazing list and there's actually a lot of motivated sellers with these lists. So they're really good to go after. Here's the biggest issue. everyone goes after tax delinquency lists. So you won't be the first investor to actually talk to people who are tax delinquent on their properties or is behind on their taxes. Unfortunately, it's a very saturated list because it's an amazing list. Now, I can be like a guru who's telling you this is a hidden secret list that no one talks about. I'm just going to be honest with you. A lot of people do it, but they don't approach it the right way. So in this video, again, I'm giving you a step-by-step guide actually how to find and wholesale tax delinquency lists. We're going to go on a different approach than most real estate investors with it, so we have the best chance of getting deals from it. And again, please understand that I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a tax professional. Do not use me as your tax lawyer advice. And everything I say on this, please make sure it's state specific for you. Some states do tax deeds, tax sales, tax liens. Please understand what your state is and how they actually deal with taxes. Every county is different in a way, but really I'm trying to make this as general as possible and give you my experience here in Florida on how I do tax delinquent wholesale deals. So how do we actually find tax delinquent lists? Now there's two really easy ways to do it. The free way is you just go to the local clerk of the court or the public records and you just look up and get the full list of people behind on their taxes. Now here's an important pro tip that most wholesalers don't tell you is when you're dealing with a seller that is tax delinquent, I would say from my personal experience, 30 to 50% of the time, they will not tell you that they're behind on their taxes. They'll just not mention it. Either they're embarrassed, they don't really want to talk about it too much, or they don't feel like it, or sometimes they don't even know they're behind on their taxes. They just forget to pay the taxes. Kind of crazy, but people do forget to pay their taxes and it is not a good situation when they do. So if you want to know if you're talking to a current seller right now and they have taxes, or you're giving them an offer and they owe $90,000 on a mortgage and they have a $10,000 tax lien and you just offered them $100,000 and you want to know that $100,000 offer, they'll literally get $0. What you want to do, go back to the clerk of the court or the public recording office, search their name, Smith-John, it's probably a little more specific, and you can actually pull up and see what the tax liens are there. They'll probably record a lien on the property, and you can actually look it up absolutely for free. That's another quick tip for your sellers if you want to know if they're actually behind on their taxes, but you can't pull a full list doing that, but you could call the clerk of the court and request the full list. Now, number two, which is the easiest way to do it, just go to listrei.com, listrei.com. Literally, just click your city, go to filter, click down there to tax lien, and then boom, everything will probably pop up right there. Easy to go, export that list and go after it. So finding the tax delinquency list is very easy. That's why most wholesalers do them, because they're really easy to do. And again, when you're actually reaching out to tax delinquency leads, it's never about being the first guy there or the slickest talker. It's all about timing. Once you find someone who's tax delinquent, if you talk to them day one, that right when they hit the list, they'll tell you, I'm not behind the taxes, or I'll get the money to do it. I don't want to sell it right now. Maybe you go to month two, they'll say, no, I'm not really interested in selling it right now. Month three, month four, you keep calling them, they won't say it. But let's say magically month five or six, they get a letter and they actually figure out that there's going to be a tax sale that's going to go very soon on the property, or something even crazier happened and now they can't afford next year's taxes. Month seven or eight, they'll say, you know what, Zach, this is the perfect timing. I can't believe you called me at this time. This is really stressing me out. Let's sell it. The biggest reason you'll get a deal from a tax delinquency list is when you've hit someone on the perfect timing. So yes, there could be seven people cold calling a tax delinquency list, but if you hit them at the right month, time, or date, you will be the one that gets that deal. We have to understand that, which will affect the way we actually go after sellers and actually market to them. So now we got the list. We know what we have to do. Timing is everything. So the best way to do it, in my opinion, are these three marketing strategies. The best way to actually go after a seller for tax delinquency, someone who's behind on taxes, has a tax lien, is just to cold call them. Honestly, pull that list, skip trace that list. You can use truepeoplesearch.com, batch leads, use honestly whatever service you really want and skip trace that list and then cold call them. Now, another one you can do is just go to smszach.com and literally just SMS blast a list like that. Same thing as cold calling, you just blast the list. And number three would be door knocking. Those are the three best strategies for them. Please understand this. When we're contacting these sellers, we're gonna have to be a lot different than the average wholesaler that goes after tax delinquency. Yes, timing is everything. Our approach can be extremely important also on getting the deal or not. So when I'm cold calling, SMS text blasting, or even door knocking, I'm not gonna be like the average comes to a tax delinquency. They usually do two approaches. They do a, hey, I'm a real estate investor and I'm looking to buy your property for all cash. I'm gonna get an amazing deal off of you and wholesale it for a big profit. You're gonna turn the guy off, most likely not building any rapport and not helping anyone. Number two, I see some other gurus really talking about this. They say, come out at this angle where I'm a tax professional strategist and I can help you with your options on actually saving your home. You can go with me, I can give you a loan, but maybe I can be the wholesaler for you. That approach works a little better, but honestly, you're kind of sleazy when it comes to that. People know you're still trying to make a profit off of you and you're not really being a friend. The most important way to actually get through some of these sellers and break that barrier of them not wanting to talk to you, they're embarrassed, is just be a friend. Build a rapport and honestly, be a friend that's there for a solution. What would you do if your best friend was behind 2 years on their taxes? Would you go say, hey, I'm a tax professional strategist and I can give you some options to help you save the property? And you're all like that, or say, I'm an investor looking to make money off of you. What if you just go after them and say, honestly, what's going on? How can I help? How are you in this situation? And what can I do to actually help you out? Really? Wow. What are you trying to accomplish? Like, what are you trying to get done? Care about them, actually understand their situation, empathize with them, be a compassionate human being with these people, and you will understand their wants and their needs, and you can provide a solution maybe to them to help them out of a situation. Just going that approach and not being the slick saleswoman or salesman, it's not gonna give you the best result. And honestly, just being a human and just being compassionate will get you more deals than not. Just being a compassionate person and just being a giver and just helping will give you so many good deals. Now, I'm not gonna get the whole karma thing and everything like that, but actually just being a friend to someone, they'll trust you a lot more. You can build their rapport and you'll get the deal. So going after that approach will help you so much. So let's say when you're cold calling, say, hey, my name's Zach. I'm actually looking to buy a couple properties. Would you be by chance interested in selling one? Something like that when you're cold calling someone is a lot better than if you go after, hey, John, I just saw you're behind on your taxes and I want to buy your property. First, it's embarrassing. It's an invasion of privacy for them. If you go after with my approach, where you're just being a friend or you didn't even realize that the guy is behind on his taxes and he revealed it to you, it seems like I'm not going after you just because you're behind on your taxes. That's a good approach I do. I do that with my probates. I do that with a lot of my situations where I don't explicitly say why I'm contacting them because they're on the certain list. I basically say, oh, this is kind of out of the blue. I'm just looking to buy some more properties in that neighborhood. It seems like it was fate that you contacted them at this perfect time. You're actually nice, you're a compassionate person, and you can actually buy houses. This could be really cool. And that will give you the best success at actually contacting these sellers. So once you get the conversation going and you're actually talking to somebody and they're behind on their taxes, you build that rapport, you're being compassionate. What I do recommend if you're physically wholesaling is set up an appointment to actually go to the property, meet with them, get the contract signed there. If you're doing virtual wholesaling, you can get your boots on the grounds there. And once you have that conversation with them, get the lowest price possible. Make sure they always say no on the first offer. Figure out what the ARV is. It's extremely similar to calculating offers with a mortgage. The guy owes $100,000 on the property and there's a $10,000 tax lien and the property's worth $200,000. You can do an MAO on it, maximum allowable offer. Or the way that I like to do it personally is, hey, I know a cash buyer will give me $150,000 for this property. I know the guy owes $100,000 on it. He has a $10,000 tax lien, which means if I break even, he'll get $40,000. See if he wants to walk away with $20,000. So if I put it under contract for $130,000, I can sell to a cash buyer for $150,000. I get a check for $20,000. Easy as that, they're good to go. That's another way you just calculate the offers. That's my personal favorite, but you could still do the MAO thing and just understand that they'll owe those taxes at the closing. So in that situation, I'll offer the lowest possible. Again, most of the time sellers don't want to pay at the closing. You know, if I offer them $80,000, that means they'd owe $20,000 out of their pocket at the closing. They have to cut a check at that. It's extremely rare that'll ever happen. So just don't do that. Make sure they walk away with something because you want to make sure it's a win-win situation for everyone also. Then when you have an offer on it, make sure you know again before you meet with these people if the person is married, they have a spouse. Make sure you understand that so all the decision makers are in the room when talking to the seller. Sign the contract there, virtually, wherever you really want to do it. Now what you're going to do is you're going to set the stage for wholesaling it and say, hey, Mr. Seller, so we can walk away so I can buy this property cash. My partner might need to come by the property next week. Is that okay if they do? They just want to check on the property also. I don't recommend you lie to your sellers at all, but you're not lying if your cash buyer is your partner. And actually, they are my partners in these deals because they buy it and they give me my money. So then you set the stage there for a cash buyer going through. They'll offer you more than what your contract is. Boom, you make a profit, close, and repeat. So that's basically it. That's how you actually find and wholesale tax delinquent properties. It's not that complicated. It's like wholesaling with any list, except you got to know the steps on it. Walk with your seller on the actual process on being behind on taxes. I can't really give you one here because I don't know your state. I don't know your county's regulations. But what you want to do to get really knowledgeable with the tax situations in your county or state. What's the process? Do they do a tax deed, a tax lien? How many months or years until they actually take over property? What I want you to do is call the actual tax assessor's office, the clerk of the court, the public recordings, basically any government service that is really in charge in your county, city specifically when it comes to actually doing tax liens and tax sales. Ask them all these questions. They'll be very knowledgeable on it and they'll give you lots of free information. So you can go and give that information to your sellers so you can be as confident as possible talking to them. I truly appreciate you guys watching this video. I hope you got some value out of this. If you really like this video, again, please smash that like button and subscribe. It really helps me out with this YouTube algorithm so more people can get free content like this. Again, this is $5,000 of course material I just give out absolutely for free just because I want to be a giver to you guys. No one did it to me when I was starting out in this business. So I truly appreciate you guys watching this. Again, thank you guys so much and have a blessed day.